إن أعجبك الفيديو لا تنسى الإعجاب والاشتراك في القناة.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله الكريم الوهاب الرحيم التواب غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن وهو بكل شيء عليم. ما يكون من نجوى ثلاثة إلا هو رابعهم ولا خمسة إلا هو سادسهم ولا أدنى من ذلك ولا أكثر إلا هو معهم أينما كانوا ثم ينبئهم بما عملوا يوم القيامة إن الله بكل شيء عليم. وأشهد أن سيدنا وعظيمنا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. ثم أما بعد أيها الإخوة الأحباب أيتها الأخوات الكريمات، نضر الله سبحانه وتعالى هذه الوجوه المتواضئة، أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يتقبلني وإياكم في الصالحين وأن يغفر لنا الذنوب وأن يستر عنا العيوب وأن يحشرني وإياكم في مستقر رحمته تحت ظل عرشه يوم لا ينفع مال ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. اللهم آمين يا رب العالمين. Dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, we should fear Allah Azza wa Jal, Almighty God, as He should be feared. I testify that there is no God but Allah, and Muhammad is the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Always speak the truth. Do good as much as you can. Dear brothers, subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, into many ayat, verses in the Holy Quran, He asked us to remember Him as much as we can, to make zikr, to purify and glorify His name and praise Him, to many verses in the Holy Quran. But my point today is your tasbih, your zikr, can stop your qadr and your qada, your destiny? Yes. Yes, big yes. It is in the Holy Quran. More you make zikr, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا اُذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا. O you who believed, remember Allah as much as you can, ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. Glorify and praise His name in the morning and the evening and in the middle of the day and part of the night too. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. More you remember Allah, that zikr can stop your qadr and your destiny. Allah can replace it to something good. Can He change it for you? Dear brothers, see, for example, in the story of Prophet Jana, Allah mentioned it in Surah Al-Anbiya, the chapter of the prophets. He mentioned it in Surah Noon, in too many chapters in the Quran. We have chapter in the Quran by his name, Prophet Jana. He was in Nineveh, in Iraq. Subhanallah. What happened to him? Allah sent him to his people, and they did not listen to him. They disobeyed him in a very bad way. He was very distressed because of that. And what happened? He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He lifted them and they said, Allah will punish you guys. I'm leaving. What happened? You know the rest of the story. He ended where? In the stomach of the whale. The darkness of the stomach of the whale, the darkness of the night, the darkness of the ocean. He was into that. And what happened to him? He recognized his mistakes. We are human, even the prophets too. He recognized what he did. You cannot leave your people and you say, this is the punishment is coming. You are a prophet, you are not me and you. Subhanallah. But what happened is, he repented and he remembered Allah. What did he say? He said, La ilaha illa anta. سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. الله سبحانه وتعالى أنصر به. فاستجبنا له ونجيناه من الغم وكذلك ننجي المؤمنين. Oh, this ayah is not just for Jonah. It is for us too. The meaning of this beautiful dua and the beautiful zikr. To get out of your anguish, out of your problems, out of your sickness, out of your poverty, out of your misguidance, out of your enemy. Subhanallah, just say this dua. What did he say? Yunus alayhi salam, Jonah. لا إله إلا أنت. He started with tawheed. The best thing to remember Allah with is tawheed. Allah created the heaven, the earth, sent the prophets, the messengers. He created Jannah and hellfire for tawheed. What is tawheed? The monotheism. The oneness of Allah. Allah is one. لا إله إلا الله. قل هو الله أحد. That's it. This is the best. You cannot go Allah. If you make all good deeds without لا إله إلا الله, it's not working. Allah is one, the creator. That's why Yunus said, alayhi salam, you are the only one God. No one else worthy of worship except you. Pure are you. Forgive me. He asked for forgiveness. Forgive me. Indeed, I was among the wrongdoers. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. Arabic language, the grammar, فَا لِلْتَعْقِيم. Immediately, Allah answered. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered his dua. فَا فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. The same dua of Moses. When he helped the daughters, these girls, the daughters of that pious man. And what did he say? He was escaping from Pharaoh. He went to Jordan. And he helped these girls without any conditions. Subhanallah. فَسَقَى لَهُمَا ثُمَّ تَوَلَّى إِلَى الظِّلِّ. He went and he sat under the shade of the tree. فَقَالَ. And raised his hand to Allah. That's why brothers and sisters, learn from these anbiya. فَقَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي لِمَا أَنزَلْتَ إِلَيَّ مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَقِيرٍ. Oh Allah, I am in need to you. Oh Allah, I am poor. I am miskin. You know my situation. رَبِّ إِنِّي لِمَا أَنزَلْتَ إِلَيَّ مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَقِيرٍ. Immediately, Allah answered. Just he dropped his hand. He finished his dua. فَجَاءَتْهُ إِحْدَاهُمَا تَمْشِي عَلَى اسْتِحْيَاءٍ. فَا, again, receive the fa in Arabic. لِلْتَعْقِيمِ means immediately Allah answered. And one of the girls came and said, come to my dad. He's asking for you. Brothers, learn how to deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded to him, rescued him from his distress, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala delivered him out of his anguish. And this verse for us until the day of judgment, وَكَذَلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. The same as well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save the believers. It is not just for Jonah, alayhi salam. Whenever you feel that you are in distress, you are in problem, just raise your hand to Allah. Make zikr to Allah. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save and will survive you. Dear brothers, when you make zikr, your zikr can stop your qadr, can change it. Imagine that if Jonah stayed in the stomach of the whale until the day of judgment. فَلَوْلَا أَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ. Because he used to make zikr and tasbih to Allah. لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِهِ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. He will stay in the stomach of the whale until the day of judgment. Allahu Akbar. The day of resurrection. Dear brothers, think about that. Tasbih, zikr. Remember Prophet David alayhi salam, Dawood alayhi salam. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala subjugated to him al-jibal, the mountains and the birds, to repeat the zikr, the tasbih with David. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the knowledge and the understanding of the tasbih of the mountains and the birds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَسَخَّرْنَا مَعَ دَاوُودَ الْجِبَالَ يُسَبِّحْنَا وَالطَّيْرِ. Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and we blessed David, Dawood, with knowledge
of knowing to manipulate the mountains to praise us, and also the birds doing that as well. Dear brothers, everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did create, they are praising Allah. They are glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's name. قال وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ. Every shay, everything, they are praising, glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we cannot understand. وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِحَهُمْ. أَلَمْ تَرَى, didn't you see, O Muhammad, أَلَمْ تَرَى, didn't you see, أَنَّ اللَّهَ يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Everything on the earth and in the heaven, they are praising and glorifying Allah's name subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look to Prophet Zechariah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gifted him with Prophet John, Yahya, what happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, stay in your mihrab for 3 days. Subhanallah. This is a sign. And then Zechariah, when he get out of his mihrab, the place of worship, they call this mihrab. The mihrab, when he was finishing these 3 days, فَخَرَجَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ مِنَ الْمِحْرَابِ. He was out from his mihrab. And he went to his people. What did he say? فَخَرَجَ عَلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ مِنَ الْمِحْرَابِ فَأَوْحَىٰ إِلَيْهِمْ أَنْ سَبِّحُوا بُكْرَةً وَعَشِيَّةً. He said, glorify, praise Allah's name. بُكْرَةً means in the morning, وَعَشِيَّةً means in the evening. It was the dua and the wish of Prophet Moses alayhi salam. What did Prophet Moses say? Surah Taha said that. So qala rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli waj'al li waziran min ahli harun akhi. Why? أشتد به أزري وأشركه في أمري. Why? كي نسبحك كثيرا ونذكرك كثيرا إنك كنت بنا بصيرا. قال قد أوتيت سؤلك يا موسى. Moses عليه السلام, he asked Allah saying, يا رب, please make my brother Aaron, Harun, make him as my wazir, helper. Why? To make me strong, because I'm gonna face big trial. Fir'aun, Pharaoh. And who's Pharaoh? They used to claim he's higher than Allah. Quran said that. قَالَ أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى. الْأَعْلَى أَفْعَلِ التَّفْضِيلِ means I am higher than the God of Moses. Pharaoh said that. الْأَعْلَى, الْأَعْلَى means higher than Allah. استغفر الله. This is what Fir'aun claimed. He used to claim that. It was a big trial for Musa. And he said, Ya Rab, please help me with my brother Aaron, Harun. Why? To strengthen me. And number two, to help me to remember you much, to glorify your name. وَنَذْكُورَكَ كَثِيرًا. Dhikr is very important for us as Muslims, dear brothers and sisters. And the dhikr, even in Jannah, you remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do you know if you need anything in Jannah, inshallah, when we go, all of us, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring all of us together in Jannah al-Firdaws al-A'la. Say Ameen, Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. When we go to Jannah, inshallah, if you need anything there, you don't have to call the waitress and somebody standing and all of this. No, 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 no. Just anything will hit your mind immediately. Just to say these words, two words, Subhanaka Allahumma. That's it. Allah said that in Surah Yunus. What did Allah say?
دعواهم فيها سبحانك اللهم وتحيتهم فيها سلام وآخر دعواهم أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.
When you go to Jannah, you need anything, any wish, just say سبحانك اللهم. That's it. سبحانك اللهم means you are praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the dhikr of Jannah. Dhikr wa tasbih also lil malaika. Malaika, the angels of Allah, He created them to worship Him. They've been created without any desire. Some of their act of worship, some of them they are bound, some of them they are prostrating themselves to Allah, some of them they are purifying and praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also part of their job to ask forgiveness for you as a believers. As believers or as a mu'mineen, as a believer. الملائكة, Allah said, والملائكة يسبحون بحمد ربهم. The angels, they are praising Allah, purifying His name. ويستغفرون لمن في الأرض. And they are seeking forgiveness for those who are on the earth. فسبحان الله وبحمده عدد خلقه ورضا نفسه وزنة عرشه ومداد كلماته. And the tasbih with zikr, when you purify and praise the name of Allah, has relationship with satisfaction and the contentment. More you make zikr and you glorify Allah's name, you will be satisfied. Allah will give satisfaction and contentment to your heart. That's why, brothers, don't stop. We are driving a lot in this country, right? Sometimes you drive 4 hours, 5 hours. Instead of listening to this and thinking about that and talking about this, just say, make tasbih. Wallahi, make zikr. That's all will be in your record. And you, Allah will solve too many of your problems because of this tasbih and zikr. Look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us. The relationship between zikr Allah and being satisfied. Allah said,
وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ وَقَبْلَ غُرُوبِهَا وَمِنْ آنَاءِ اللَّيْلِ فَسَبِّحْ وَأَطْرَافَ النَّهَارِ
Why?
لَعَلَّكَ تَرْضَى.
Beautiful Quran, beautiful, beautiful. Allahu Akbar. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ. Purify, praise Allah's name. قَبْلَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ. Before the sunrise. يعني praise Salat al-Fajr. Sit down 1 hour and make zikr, purify Allah's name until the sunrise. Pray to rak'ah, get ajr, hajj and umrah, and satisfaction. And he said, وَقَبْلَ غُرُوبِهَا, before the sunset, from asr time to maghrib time, that time make tasbih. Remember Allah, say subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu akbar, astaghfirullah. There are too many zikr. Imam al-Nawawi has a book, you can go on the internet, Al-Adhkar for Imam al-Nawawi. Say Al-Adhkar. You can get it even in English. You can read this type of Azkar before sunset and before sunrise and before sunset. وَمِنْ آلَاءِ اللَّيْلِ. Sometimes at night. وَأَطْرَافًا فَسَبِّحْ. Purify Allah's name. وَأَطْرَافَ النَّهَارِ. لَعَلَّكَ تَرْضَى. If you do that, you will be satisfied. You will be content. Subhanallah. Even, dear brothers, zikr Allah, tasbih, it is the cure from all kinds of problems. Subhanallah, you will be survived. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, while he was at Mecca, 13 years, the idolaters, those who used to worship idols, statues, they used to harm Rasulullah a lot. Some of them, they used to tell him, you are a poet. Some of them, they used to say, you are a magician. Some of them, they used to say, you are just an insane man. You are insane. You are majnoon. Some of them, they used to beat Rasulullah up. Yes. Remember when he came back from Taif? Remember when he was praying around the Kaaba and they get the distance of the camel, the filth of the camel, and they put it between his shoulders when he was praying? Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And sometimes, because Rasulullah, he was a human too, like us. Sometimes his heart became like very tight. He was sad, grieving, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I have a prescription for you, O Muhammad. I have a cure from this kind of sadness and grief in your heart. I know they are harming you. They are talking about you. Subhanallah. Look what Allah said. وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ. Last verse in Surah Al-Hijr. And the chapter of Al-Hijr. وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ. وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ يَضِيقُ صَدْرُكَ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ. وَلَقَدْ نَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ يَضِيقُ صَدْرُكَ بِمَا يَقُولُونَ فَسَبِّحْ بِحَمْدِ رَبِّكَ وَكُمْ مِنَ السَّاجِدِينَ وَاعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. We knew, O Muhammad, these people, they hurt you a lot. They are harming you day and night. What you have to do? Just be busy. Be busy with what? reacting against them. No, 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 no. Leave them alone. Leave them alone. Just make yourself busy with the tasbih. Say, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. If somebody harm you, brothers or sisters, don't react. They are jahil, ignorant. Don't react. They talk about you. They try to put you down. They are against you. Somebody harming you in your job, in your work, in your house, in your whatever, in your life. Too many ups and downs. Don't worry about that. Just turn your face to Allah, say, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Astaghfirullah, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Astaghfirullah. But don't be like this brother. He said his wife was shouting to him and she was criticizing him. And what he did, he said, Sheikh told me, make tasbih. Do you know, he chose that tasbih and was telling her that. She was fighting with him more. What she said, حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. She said, أنت بتتحاسب عليا. You're making dua against me. And she was fighting with him again. No, why you choose this? حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. Choose something else. Say, استغفر الله. For example, استغفر الله. Leave her and run away from the house. You don't have to react. حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل means if somebody oppresses you and you say, حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل, Allah will be satisfied and will satisfy me from you. Means you're making dua against him. And he was telling his wife that she was fighting with him more, you know. You have to choose and select the right one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling Rasulullah, don't worry about it. Just make zikr and make tasbih and prostrate yourself to Allah as much as you can. And worship Allah until you die. To the last second in your life. وَاعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى أَتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. Yaqeen here means it's not certainty. It is death. Worship Allah until you die. Dear brothers, very important to make zikr, to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And some of the adab I collected for you today, brothers, when you talk to somebody, to avoid all of this distress and the problems, don't talk to somebody weak about your energy and your power. If you see somebody sad, don't talk about your happiness in front of him. Also, brothers, if you see somebody in jail, don't talk about your freedom. I can't do this because I am out. And don't do that. And also, if you see somebody barren, he has no children, don't talk about your kids. يعني, you have to be polite. Some kind of etiquette, you know. Subhanallah. And also, brothers, say good. Do good. Wish good for everybody. Dear brothers, don't eat too much. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you power to worship Him more. Don't look too much to these things around you. Allah will give you khushu' in your heart. Don't talk too much. Allah will give you wisdom and hikmah. Don't also look for the shame of others while you have a lot of shames. And you are blind about your shames, but just you're talking about the shames of others. Also, fix your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us in too many ayat in the Holy Quran, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُمَا كُنْتُ. Wherever you are, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَتْبِعِ السَّيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُوهَا. Even your relationship with yourself. When you make a sin, make good deed, will wipe it out. And your relationship with others. وَخَالِقِ النَّاسَ بِخُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ. You have to deal with people with good manners and good conduct and good akhlaq. Dear brothers, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you, I'm sure all of us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is showering us with too many of His bounties. You have to be grateful. The ulama, they said, من كان في نعمة ولم يشكر خرج منها ولم يشعر. Without any feeling that will be taken from you. You have to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dear brothers, اتق الله في ثلاث أمور. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, Al-Makr, don't mock others. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا يَحِيقُ الْمَكْرُ السَّيِّئُ إِلَّا بِأَهْلِهِ. If you mock somebody, it will be against somebody, that's who will return back to you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, don't transgress against anybody too. Allah said, إِنَّمَا بَغْيُكُمْ عَلَى أَنفُسِكُمْ. That transgression will come back to you. Don't oppress people. And also, an-nakth means if you make covenant with somebody, you promise somebody with something, don't break it. Because that's going to come back to you. And this is one of the signs of al-nifaq, the hypocrisy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala started two chapters of the Quran with the word, wail say, وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفَّفِينَ and وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ. He said, وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ. Woe to those who are backbiting others or talking bad about others in their absence. Wow, woe to them, woe to them, hellfire. And he said, this is the quality al-a'rad, when you talk about the honor of others in his absence. And also about the money and the properties of others. Be away from this. Because Allah said also, this is the only two chapters of the Quran, started with wail. وَيْلٌ لِكُلِّ هُمَزَةٍ لُمَزَةٍ. وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ. When you deal with others in business and trade, be away from their properties. Dear brothers, we have to understand our deen and our Quran. When you love somebody, and I am sure you love your family and your kids, try to advise them in a nice way, to come to the Salah, to read the Quran, to come to the Masjid, because Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, Prophet Ibrahim, when he was advising his dad, and while his dad, his job to make idols, statues to people to worship them, and Sayyidina Ibrahim, his son, subhanallah. Imagine the Prophet, he sleeps in the house which is around his bed and table and everything around, what? Statues. And he's coming to destroy these statues. Allah sent him for that. He said when he was advising his son, his father, Azar, إني أخاف أن يمسك عذاب من الرحمن. I am afraid Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will touch you with his punishment. Will punish you with his punishment. That's why if you really care about your family, your kids, and those whom you love, advise them to come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the reality of al-hub. Dear brothers, we are human beings. Nobody can claim his excellent and his perfect. Come to Allah even with what? If you are walking not straight like all of us, if you are limping and you're coming to Allah, still come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Means, if your ibadah is not perfect, pray more. If you're still making sin, ask Allah for forgiveness and come to Allah again. Don't give up. Don't be away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The hadith said, لا تترك سترة العبادة وإن كانت مرقعة. Subhanallah. وإن كانت مرقعة. الإمام الشافعي قال سيروا إلى الله عرجا ومكاسير ولا تنتظروا الصحة فإن انتظار الصحة بطالة. Means سيروا إلى الله عرجا ومكاسير, means even if you're breaking in your salah, your salah is not perfect, your wudu is not perfect, your Islam is not perfect, your ibadah is not perfect, still stay in the way of Allah. Because if you say, no, I'm not coming because my salah is not good, that's why I'm not praying. Shaitan sometimes comes to you telling, no. Even if your salah is not perfect, come and pray. Even if you're not making perfect ibadah, pray, stay in your way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Otherwise, you will be neglected. You die without anything. At least make something during your life and invest it for ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to please Him. Inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Yaqulu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كل ابن آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوابون توبوا إلى الله واستغفروه يغفر لكم.
إن أعجبك الفيديو لا تنسى الإعجاب والاشتراك في القناة.